Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Centrum Broking, I welcome you all to the Q4FY18 conference call of Tata Sponge. We are glad to host the senior management of the company represented by Mr. Sanjay Patnaik, the MD, Mr. S.K. Mishra, the CFO, and Mr. Sanjay Kasture, the company secretary. We'll start with initial comments from the management about the results and the future outlook, and then we'll open the floor for Q&A. So now I'll hand over the floor to Mr. Patnaik for his initial comments. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you, Avi sir, and good morning to all the participants. It's a pleasure speaking to you once again. Absolutely good numbers, very impressive result in FY18, and we have recorded improvement in all fronts, be it the operations, be it the cost reduction, be it the maintenance activities, or even the various business excellence initiatives that we started in the company, and those have all given us very good results. So our journey for excellence will continue. Last year has been 107% capacity utilization as far as the sponge and production is concerned, and as far as coal DRI, I think this is probably the best in the country. And while the industry average for coal-based DRI is about 60%, Tata Sponge has operated at 107%. The net realization year-on-year has registered a growth of about 40%. So therefore, coupled with the good volumes and the good realization, we have posted the highest ever PBT for the company. The Q4 has been the best ever quarter again in the company's history. The quarter-on-quarter NR has increased. Quarter-on-quarter NR was 20% increase, about 20% increase. Q3, the NR was about 17,000 rupees a ton, and Q4, it was 21,000. So therefore, that's a good number. There has been increase in the raw material cost. Primarily the raw material, both in iron ore as well as in coal, quarter on quarter, but the increase in iron ore has been less in comparison to the increase in coal. And the year on year also, there has been increase in the raw material input cost, but again it is primarily the coal. Coal costs have gone up. And one of the big challenges that we are facing presently now is logistics challenge, which for getting our coal from the ports, availability of wagons have become a major issue. Therefore, sometimes we have to even source our coal from ports which are situated far from our plant, that is Gangavaram, Isaac, rather than Paradip. We expect that FY19, with the manufacturing sector picking up, we expect that the realization will remain in the same region and all, maybe there could be a little fluctuation, and there could be increase in the coal prices, but I don't see any substantial increase in the iron ore price. Rather, the iron ore price has sort of settled in after the initial problems that they faced in December because of the Supreme Court, under the Supreme Court's order, where the penalty was recovered from the miner. And we have set a target for 425,000 tons next year. That is the maximum environment clearance limit that is set by the government. So we would, in the meantime, apply for revising the environment clearance, and maybe with operational improvements, operational initiatives, try and further increase the throughput of our kiln. And the growth project that I talked to you last year, last time, still work in progress. We are evaluating various options with our parent company. And soon, once we finalize and all that, I will be happy to come back and inform all of you. So that's the sort of overall scenario of the company during the last year. I will be happy to take any questions. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the attached tone phone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We will take the first question from the line of Bhavin Chera from Enam Holdings. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Congrats on good set of numbers and over 100% utilization. Sir, can you update us on the steel project you are planning, at what stage it is, and what would be capex, and what are the timelines for it, one? And the other, if you can share with us the iron ore landed and the coal landed cost in the quarter and full year?
Yes. steel project is... We are very serious about the growth project, and that's a project we've been pursuing. And this is being evaluated, the process route, the various options that are available to us. So that's all being evaluated, and it's still work in progress. And I can only say that our project team is working very, closely with several consultants, technology suppliers. And once we finalize and we get the board's approval, then we come back and inform you. Capex on that? Well, it will depend on the size of the plant, the product mix, and the process route. So that, I think, will take some time. But once it is finalized, we'll come back. Your next question was on the landed cost of coal. Landed cost of coal, FY17 was about 6,500 rupees a ton. FY18, it has increased to about 8,000 rupees a ton. And iron ore, which was about 2,100 rupees approx, increased to about 2,500 rupees a ton.
Are you getting 100% iron ore from Tata Steel, or you still buy from outside?
No, I'm SK Mishra speaking. He's having some throat problem, so I am taking over. Good morning to all of you.
Yeah, good morning, sir. Yeah.
Yeah. currently we are sourcing all our iron ore from Tata Steel. Mostly it is from Tata Steel. In case of a shortfall, we go to the market. Otherwise, we manage to get it from Tata Steel.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Giriraj Daga from KM Visaria Family Trust. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hello team. So what is the sponge and production and sales volume in this fourth quarter?
We have produced in the fourth quarter, it's about 1.06 lakh.
Okay.
And sold around 1.08 lakh tons.
Okay. And what were the particularly iron ore costs in the fourth quarter? You mentioned about the full year.
Yeah, iron ore cost in the fourth quarter is somewhere around 2,900 rupees.
2,900 rupees. Okay, and it's more or less linked to the, like, how do we see the price going forward, since it's all captive coming from the parent company. So how do we see the prices? Is it linked with the, like, NMDC price announcement?
Yeah, it is linked to OMC price announcement because that is the nearer source and quality of iron ore is more or less similar.
So there has been some correction in the beginning of April onwards?
No, there is hardly anything because OMC prices have not undergone any change.
Okay, okay. And how is the, like, you gave the realization last quarter, last full quarter was 21,000. How is the April so far?
April is going more or less in the same line. There was some drop in the NR, but again we are hopeful we will be recovering in the balance period.
Okay, okay. Thanks a lot, sir. All the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Saumil Mehta from BNP Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, so just wanted to check your update on the steel project. I mean, slightly a hypothetical one. Since, you know, Tata Steel has bid for Bhushan Power and Steel, which has a long product portfolio, in that event, do we still plan to go ahead? Because, you know, if I believe our long product was in conjunction with Tata Steel going into long products. So, you know, how should we look at that overall scenario now?
No, right now, although Tata Steel, the announcement has come for taking over Bhushan Steel, as a separate company, separate listed company and all, we have our plans. So, we are with those plans. Of course, the board has not cleared it. We are as MD clarified.
Okay.
Into the technology process and other things. But I hopefully it will not impact us.
Okay. And so my second question is, you know, what would be an alternate supply source, you know, I mean, because even Tata Steel is expanding its own capacity and now with Bhushan Steel into the kitty, they would have to supply iron ore over there as well. So, I mean, in a scenario where we don't get enough material from Tata Steel, what is the other option do we have? And in terms of landed cost and the grade, how different can it be?
In fact, Tata Steel may require an additional quantity of ore to fit to their new plants.
Sure.
But simultaneously, the good news is that Orissa government is coming up with new iron ore mines where we are also participating.
Uh-huh.
Past also, we participated in iron ore blocks, you must be knowing. So somehow we could not succeed in those auctions.
Uh-huh.
With new number of mines coming up for auction, we are hopeful in times to come we will be able to manage something. But till that time, we do not expect any problem from for supply from Tata Steel, and it should continue.
So you know, let me ask you the way, you know, in terms of our iron ore sourcing, how much comes from Tata Steel and how much comes from non-Tata Steel?
Right now, 100% is from Tata Steel.
Okay, and what would be the landed cost? I just missed that number. What was the landed cost in Q4?
It will be around 2,900 rupees a ton.
2,900 rupees a ton. Okay, okay. And what are the spot prices for the sponge as of now?
It is going at the same level of about 20,000 rupees.
At about 20. But, you know, sir, I believe that the exit rate was a bit higher. So is it fair to assume that there can be a marginal upside on a Q-on-Q basis to the realization?
Actually, the price has dropped for some time at the end of the month and in the beginning of this new period.
Okay.
And I think we are expecting that it will stabilize.
Sure.
It will be in the similar range as that of fourth quarter of last year.
Okay, fine. Got it. Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Jatin Damania from Kotak Securities. Please go ahead.
Sir, just wanted to clarify, sir, the iron ore cost for the last quarter you said was 2,500 or 2,900 per ton?
It is 2,900 rupees per ton.
2,900. And what was the total power sale generation and the sales during the quarter?
Power sale, I will just give you the figures. In quarter four, we generated about 50 million units and sold about 37 million units.
Sold this. Okay, sir. So thank you. That's all from my side. That's all the questions has been answered. Thank you.
The next question is from the line of Parthiv Jansa from NVS Brokerage. Please go ahead.
Hi. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
So I just wanted to know the total production and the sale for the entire year, FY18, and what was the target going forward?
During FY18, we produced 4.17 lakh tons of sponge iron.
Okay, and you sold, sir?
We sold 4.14 lakhs.
Okay. And going forward, sir?
Going forward, we are taking up some improvement projects we are expecting and taking a target of producing about 4,25,000 tons.
I believe that's like the maximum limit, right, if not mistaken?
Yeah, it's because okay. The nameplate capacity of the plants is 3,90,000.
Okay.
Percent level.
Okay. And so I believe the international markets of iron have been easing off along with the coal. So how do you perceive it going forward? Do you expect it to ease more or be on the same level or to go up in coming months?
For iron ore, hardly we are impacted by international prices. So domestic front, with new mines coming up and the old mines are getting opened, Honorable Supreme Court's order, we do not see that there will be much change in the supply problem or anything like that. The prices should continue at this level. Whereas, so far coal is concerned, remain volatile, and because we are dependent on imported coal, more or less 100%, about 90% we consume imported coal.
Yeah.
A likely chance of fluctuation in the price.
Now,
it's around about $110.
Okay. And you import everything from Australia or?
No. We consume from South Africa.
Okay, from South Africa. Okay, perfect. Okay, thank you, sir. I'm done with my questions. Thank you.
Before we take the next question, we would like to remind the participants that you may press star and one to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Gaurav Agarwal from ENR Advisors. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir, for the opportunity and congratulations for good set of numbers. Sir, on the steel plant, you know, hypothetically, if we go for 1 million tons of steel capacity, so how much of the sponge iron will we be able to consume? You know, we have 4 lakh tons of production on sponge iron. So how much can we consume and how much do we have to source outside?
Yeah, I'm back. This is Sanjay Patnaik again. Thanks, Gaurav.
Yes.
When we decide the steel plant, like I said, it's still work in progress. But when we decide, finalize, that it would depend on the charge mix. If we are, as of now, there are various options. And what we are contemplating is, if we go through electric arc furnace route and all, then there up to 25% would be the sponge iron. Balance would be the liquid metal. We will have a blast furnace, we will have a sinter plant, we will have a coke oven.
Okay.
That is how to bring down the electricity cost, the power cost.
Okay.
So all those are being just worked out and all that. And you know, whatever is the best possible option, the maximum return, and product should be of course of high quality. And like we have a great advantage. We have the support of Tata Steel.
So that is true.
One of the top steel companies of the world is behind us. So therefore, we have that advantage.
So one question on this, you know, if we go with the EAF basis, you know, electronic arc furnace, so our thought process will be to consume sponge iron internally, right? We won't sell it out then. We will consume the sponge iron internally. That should be the thought, so that we can move up the value chain and have better pricing and better margin.
Look, part of it could be consumed, part of it could be sold.
Okay.
50% of it could be consumed.
How much of it, sir?
What is the return that we are getting and all that?
Which is
the option? Maybe, definitely some will be consumed. Maybe 100% could be consumed.
Okay.
And then part consumed, part sold, so all that is...
Hmm.
It's very premature to now say that
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Jitendra Gupta from Money Control. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, Mr. Hello. Gupta, good morning to you.
Morning, sir, and congratulations for good set of numbers. I just wanted to understand at the end of after this Q4, what is the cash we have in the balance sheet now?
What is the cash at the end of Q4? What is that?
Oh, at the end of Q4, we are having a cash balance of somewhere around 660 crores.
660 crores? Plus, we are due to get that 200 crores we are due to get from the coal block that is pending with the government.
Yeah, so the next question was about, you know, any update on that, about the dues?
Again, please, I could not get it.
Any update about the dues? Is the government confirming that they will be giving it any timelines or something?
No. As you know, recently the Ministry of Coal, again based on the High Court decision, Honorable High Court of Delhi, they asked to file us a new claim to the nominating agency that has been filed. And this money, as per the coal ordinance, it has to come from the future buyer of the block. So, because those things are not under our control, predicting something is not correct.
Yes. Well, okay. Now, sir, one last question. Just wanted to understand. We are already operating at 107% capacity utilization. We are in a cycle where the realizations are at peak. You know, we have seen a significant improvement in realization. So going forward in FY19 or FY20 for the next 2-3 years, where do you think the growth will come from, you know, because if volumes are not going to go up, if realizations remain at the current level, you know, what will drive the growth, basically?
Volumes are going up. No, I said 4,25,000. Volumes
Go up. Yeah. And this 35,000 would be largely based on your whatever the program you are doing to unlock the production from the existing cluster.
Yes, that's right. The improvement initiatives that we have already rolled in. And look, 390 for the first time we touched last year.
Yes.
And this year, we got the environment clearance last year to increase it, and this year you already produced 417. So it will go up. We'll keep on improving. And this is, like I said, it's while the industry average is 60%, we are already 107% capacity utilization.
But isn't it that next year onward you would be constrained because of the capacity, because how much more you can unlock from the production side, basically. Even if you touch 4.25, I mean, beyond that...
Then we are planning to further go up. We will again apply to the ministry. There are technological innovations, and we are already doing a lot on the innovation on our R&D, and it might still go up. Why should we stop at 425? Although it's a very difficult task, but that's the challenge before us. We should further innovate. We should further spend on R&D and then go up. We are currently having a ongoing project with IIT Bhubaneswar.
Okay. That's all from my side, sir. Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Akshat Adhiyo from Successure. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Congratulations on your result.
Thank you. Can you speak a bit loud? I'm not able to hear you.
Hello. Yes. Congratulations on your result. Excellent results this quarter.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you mentioned that there is an estimate there will be bidding for iron ore in Orissa mines, right? There would be bidding in Orissa for iron.
Bidding is on, and the next we have just participated, put in one bid, and the next auction is going to take place in first week of May.
Okay, so I wanted to know if you could highlight the estimated bidding cost for it and the capacity that it would add to the company.
Bidding cost will be difficult now. We will not be able to tell that now.
Okay.
It's a commercial requirement. And ask me this question after the bidding is over. I can tell you that.
Okay. Any idea on the capacity that it could be adding?
No, iron ore. You're talking about the iron ore, no? So I know now we are getting from our from Tata Steel captive mines, and once we have our own, I know we'll try and develop that mine for our own plant. So that would be 100% capacity, 100% captive to us, to Tata Sponge.
Okay. Thank you so much. That is all from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Abhisar Jain from Centrum Broking. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir, so as you mentioned that we could look to apply for further EC clearance in the current clearance, and that will, you know, be of, say, a similar quantum of 30-35 KT that you had got last time, if you can give some clarity around the capacity possible.
Yes, that is what, Abhishek, the technical evaluation of that is going on.
Okay.
Now you've been associated with and you've been tracking Tata Sponge for so long.
Mm-hmm.
Tata Sponge touched 390,000 tons after 32 years of its operation.
Mm-hmm.
First time it touched, and primarily because of the improvement in operational parameters, improvement in raw material quality.
Mm-hmm.
And then we thought that the capacity is 390. How do we can't be stuck there. So how do we go ahead? And that was a challenge. And then we took it up with the ministry and presented to them. And then they agreed up to giving us up to 425.
Sure.
Now we are almost going to breach that 425 mark next year.
Correct.
And if we do that, then meanwhile we have started work.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll go back to the ministry and ask again for another 35,000-40,000 tons.
Okay.
Very big task, but I'm pretty confident that with the kind of improvement initiatives, new capex that we will bring in, sustenance capex,
mm-hmm.
with that it will go up. That will give us a, the more we produce, it gives us a huge cost benefit in terms of controlling our fixed cost.
Sure, sir. Understood. And, sir, within this, plan, till the time we finalize the steel capex and the route to take, I understand that we are doing detailed studies there and we want to be sure of the route that we take. But till that time, that decision is taken, are we looking to add one or two clinks for the sponge iron in the meanwhile? Because later on it can obviously get forward integrated into whatever long products that we enter.
We still have an embargo from the government, considering in Odisha, but standalone expansion of sponge iron is not allowed.
So right, sir.
Examination, technically speaking, we will not be able to add.
Okay, understood.
Can evaluate and all that. Our trust and our focus will be to go into the next league of value addition.
Right, sir. Right. Mishra sir, can you please give the coal cost for Q4? I think for FY18 you gave, but for Q4, what was the coal landed cost for us?
Q4, I will tell you. Q4, the coal landed was 8,900.
8,900. And sir, the impact of this higher logistic cost which you talked about for coal, was that felt in Q4 also, or will we see that further in Q1 FY19?
No, Q4 also. Q4 also we felt.
And so the
500 rupees a ton or 400 rupees a ton.
Oh, okay. Additional logistics basically. And for Q1 FY19 means moving into Q1, as you mentioned that iron ore is starting to stabilize and may not go up. But coal, are we seeing it even higher than this number 8,900 per ton that we had in Q4, sir?
Could go up.
As we speak right now.
The coal prices are really fluctuating. There's a lot of fluctuation there.
Sure, sir. I think, sir, that's all from my side. We have one more question, sir, in the queue, and we'll take that and post that. You can, please give your final comments and then we'll close the call. So, operator, we can please take the final question.
Sure, sir. We'll take the last question from the line of Sanjay Satpathy from Ampersand Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir. If you can just help us understand your margin expansion in the quarter four as well as the outlook for the margin, both from a realization as well as cost point of view.
Margin quarter four was around 6,400 per ton. And margin Q1 of FY19. Be about slightly low, maybe about 6,000. About 6,000.
And can you just ask there that what really drives the margin realization here? And there were some articles that we came across relating to chromite, etc. prices going up. Does that help or hurt you?
Sanjay, I just lost you because, you're not very clear. In between, we were not able to hear you. If you don't mind, will you please repeat the question?
So, as far as your margin is concerned, you have given great details on the cost like coal, iron ore, etc. I want to understand what the price, what really will drive it. That is one. And also on the other side, there are minerals like this chromite, etc. There have been talks that there are shortage and the prices are going up. Does that help or hurt you?
Chromite we don't use and all that. So if it goes up or goes down, it really doesn't. We are immune from chromite. And but iron ore and coal and dolomite. So all iron ore, if
it's by and large it has settled in. Coal, if there is volatility in the market, it keeps fluctuating, and we keep our fingers crossed. You know, it touched 109 and has now come down to $105 CIF, and but then before that it was 99, so that keeps on fluctuating, and dolomite prices have also gone up slightly, but our consumption of dolomite is very less, so it's not, doesn't make a significant difference, coal and iron ore. And like I said, the logistics challenge still continues in coal. And the second part is, what was the...
Price side, like what really will drive the prices?
Manufacturing growth is expected to pick up. Already, there are indications that the manufacturing sector growth will take place, and we are estimating 7 to 7.5% growth. And largely, manufacturing sector will kick in, and we are very hopeful and all that. The commodity prices are also going up.
Demand, so, it overall full year margin may turn out to be higher than fiscal 18?
Overall full year margin may turn out to be in the same region or maybe slightly less. But maybe in the same region, but we are increasing our volumes, and we will also try and cut down on our costs. So that is the advantage which we are having.
Thanks a lot, sir, and all the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was the last question. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Abhisar Jain for closing comments.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir. And Sanjay, sir, you can please give your final comments before we close the call.
No, thanks. Thanks, Abhisar. Thanks. It's as usual a pleasure for me and my colleagues here to interact with our investors. And these kind of interactions also helps us in reflecting on our own performance. So sometimes the learning is both ways, and I look forward to again interacting with you after the quarter one results. And let's hope that FY19 also is as good as FY18, because FY18 has really been an exceptional and wonderful year. So that is it, and thank you again.
Surely. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for your time.
Thank you.
Operator, we can close.